Dobre utra. All right, I've got some friends from Russia here today. They just got here to the United States. Say hello to Maxim, Sergey, and Lena. I knew someday we were going to have someone who spoke Russian come to this church. And I was going to have to use my Russian. I am so rusty. Oh, my word. But it's good to have you here today. It's good to have all of you here this morning. We are excited to enter the presence of the Lord. Are you glad to be here in the house of the Lord this morning? The choir looks amazing this morning. It really filled out this since last week. We've got a lot more choir members, and they're going to be singing. Hope Sound Bible College is here today, and they're going to add to our worship today. But they're not here to perform. They're here to participate with you in worshiping our Savior Jesus Christ this morning.
Praise God.
And that's what we want to do. I want us just to bow our heads for a second. We're going to ask God's presence to come, and we're going to sing our song to the Lord this morning of praise and of worship. Heavenly Father, I thank you for Jesus. I thank you for everything that Jesus means to me. I thank you that you saved me. I thank you that you set me free. I thank you that you have been there in the darkest times of my life as my shepherd, as my companion, as my friend. I thank you, Lord, that you have lifted me up out of the deep miry clay, that you've set me on the rock, Jesus Christ. And Lord Jesus, I pray, Lord, that you'd be here today. Your presence, your Holy Spirit would settle in on this place, that we would sense you, that we would know who you are, that we would draw close to you.
Yes.
And Lord, you said if we draw close to you, you'll draw close to us. So Lord, we just pray that today you would just settle in on this place. We give you all the honor. We give you all the praise. We give you all the glory in Jesus' name. Amen. So let's stand and let's worship the Lord this morning.
All right, let's clap our hands as we sing. One, two, three, four.
I'm not afraid. song for all of the redeemed. Let the whole earth sing. The whole earth sing.
One, two, three, four.
That's when death was arrested and
Jesus. The song of the redeemed is the song that only those who are saved by Jesus Christ from their sins can sing. The angels cannot sing the song that we just sang. Death was arrested. Eternal life was given to us. Why? Because Jesus died for us. The angels can't sing that song. They sing a lot of beautiful songs, but they cannot sing that with us. That's why it's the song of the redeemed. Hallelujah. Isaiah tells us about Jesus. Isaiah 53, verse 7, it says, he was oppressed and he was afflicted, yet he opened not his mouth, like a lamb that is led to the slaughter, and like a sheep that's before its shearers is silent, so he opened not his mouth. We're preparing over the next few weeks to celebrate Good Friday, and then a few days later to celebrate Easter. Easter's the death was arrested part. Jesus overcame the grave and gave us freedom. But as we prepare our hearts for that day when he rose, we also have to remember that he died. And that's that endless love that song was just talking about. Endless love pouring over us. Greater love has no man than this, than he lays down his life for his friend. And that's what Jesus has done for us. And that's why he's worthy this morning. Amen. Jesus is worthy. Revelations chapter 5. Revelations, John is looking for someone who's worthy to open the scroll. And he can't find someone. And then they say the Lamb is worthy. The Lamb who was slain. That's the God that we're serving. Revelations 5:13 says, I heard every creature in heaven and on earth and under the earth and in the sea and all that is in them saying, to him who sits on the throne and to the Lamb be blessing and honor and glory and might forever and ever. This morning, the song of the redeemed is glory to the Lamb. Hallelujah to the Lamb. Yes. That was slain for your sins, for my sins. And this morning, we praise him for that. But we also acknowledge we need him. We needed him to die. He is worthy, but we are needy. We need forgiveness. We need redemption. We need cleansing. This morning, I want us to sing this next song in a posture of prayer. What does that mean? We're going to praise the Lord in the next song, but we're going to praise him with this understanding that we need you, Jesus. We're going to sing this next song praising God, but acknowledging, God, you are God, worthy to be praised, and come be in my life, God, right now. We are going to surrender those things that God speaks to us about. As we sing this song, I just want you to take a position, physical position of submission. Maybe you bow your head in humble reverence to the Lord for who he is. Maybe it's you raise your hands up as if you're saying, God, I need you. And like a child raises their hands to their father. Maybe it's you come and you kneel at the altar or you kneel at your seat. Maybe it's you sit down and you bow your head as we sing. Maybe it's you stand and you just close your eyes and you just receive from the Lord. But as we sing this next song of praise, let's take a position of surrender and a position of submission to the Lord as we lead into our time of prayer. Can you do that this morning? Let's sing this morning the song right now that they're singing in heaven. Let's sing it with them.
Join the song they're already. Holy are you, Lord.
He's righteous. Righteous is the way. Jesus is the Lamb. One more time. Jesus is the Lamb. Amen.
Can you give Jesus praise this morning with your voice, with your hands? Hallelujah. Part of that song, we sing the bridge, another glimpse of glory. That's referring to the cherubim, the angels who are looking into the presence of God right now, looking into the throne, and God is revealing to them a little bit more of His glory, a little bit more of His goodness, a little bit more of His faithfulness. And that song that they sing will go on forever because there is no end to the goodness of God, to the faithfulness of God. His mercies are new every morning. New every morning. Not the same. They're new every morning. Yeah. And so we sing worthy, worthy again and again for eternity. We're going to be singing the praises of our God. The angels were there in the presence of God. But because of sin, we were not able to be in the presence of God. And so Jesus made a way. Scripture says that when He said, "It is finished," and He gave up His life, the veil of the temple was rent from top to bottom. And we now have access into the Holy of Holies, into the presence of God. And we can come boldly. Why? Because of what Jesus has done. Are you grateful for that this morning? This morning, we're gonna go to the Lord in prayer. You can sit, you can stand, it doesn't matter. I'm gonna invite you to come to the altar. And during our prayer time today, we're gonna just sing another song. It's a lot of music today. We're gonna sing a song that's a prayer. And the scripture tells us that if we do not abide in the vine, we won't bear fruit. We need Jesus. We need to be in His presence. We need to be connected to God. This morning, we know Jesus can forgive us of our sins, but He wants to help us walk a daily walk with Him this morning. And perhaps you've come this morning, you have a burden, you have a need, you have a struggle, you have an addiction maybe, you have something in your life, and you just say, "God, I need You. I'm depending on You for my daily bread. I'm depending on You for resources and all the things that I have going on in my life. I need You. I have relationships that I need You to work with me on and help me through. I need strength. I need endurance. Give me Your faithfulness so I can be faithful." This morning, I'm going to invite you to come up to the altar. While we're singing the song, you can come right now. And let's just ask God for His abiding strength as we sing this prayer, okay? This is the prayer, and then we're going to close the song with a time of prayer. But if you need God's strength, if you need God's help, if you have a request, if you have a need, why don't you come to the altar this morning? We're just going to pray together this morning as we sing this song. Pray this with the choir and with the singers.
For my waking breath, for my daily bread, I depend on You. The sun to rise, for my sleep at night, I depend on You. Oh, I depend on You. You're the way, the truth, and the life. You're the way. And teach me to abide. Where the Spirit
My treasure, my prize, I am yours.
Lord Jesus, you're our well. The living water comes from you. We depend on you for everything we need. Life, breath, our daily bread, it all comes from you, Jesus. We come to you this morning, we throw ourselves on your mercy. We throw ourselves on your mercy for forgiveness, for relationship, for strength, for help, for wisdom. Lord, everything that we need, we find it in you, Jesus. Lord, we don't want to look anywhere else. We come to you. We offer ourselves living sacrifices to you, Jesus. Would you fill us with your Spirit? Would you show yourself enough today? Perhaps there's someone here today whose heart is longing for something more. Would you show them that you're enough? Perhaps there's someone who's struggling with weakness. Would you show them that through our weakness you show yourself strong? May your strength be enough. May you and your victorious resurrection, would you pour that life, that victorious resurrected life into our lives? Help us to have freedom, Lord Jesus, from death, from hell, from sin. May we live lives of obedience, Lord Jesus, through the power of your Holy Spirit. Oh, Father, we come to you acknowledging that you are worthy this morning. You are worthy. We are needed. We offer ourselves to you, Lord.
Draw me closer.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Give him praise this morning. Give him praise. God, we're so grateful for your presence. I pray, Lord, that you just continue to work in our midst today. Be with the choir as they sing. Be with the children as they go now to children's church. I pray your presence would just go right in that room and that you would speak through Megan and those who are serving the children right now. I just pray, Lord, that you'd be with us in this service, that you would continue to speak to our hearts and encourage us in your presence, Lord Jesus. And we ask this in your name. Amen. Children, you're welcome to go with Miss Megan now to Junior Church. Pastor Flavio is coming to share just a couple of announcements briefly. And then we will have Hope Sound Bible College Choir sharing some music with us.
Thank you. Good morning. How are you doing today? Oh, it's a great day. It's a blessing for us to stay here to celebrate our Savior Jesus. Praise the Lord. I'm so blessed. Since the beginning until now, I'm so blessed to be here. And right now, we have a moment to give to the Lord. We received so many, no? I'm so blessed and I'm happy because all of you helped my family with all things, and I'm so glad to you. And I'd like to share with you Proverbs 11, 24 and 25. And the Bible says, one person gives freely, yet gains even more. Another withholds unduly, but becomes to poverty. A generous person will prosper. However refreshes, other will be refreshed. A generous person will prosper. When you give to the Lord blesses our lives, just not financial situations, in all our lives we have. I would like to pray about this moment. If you would like to give for Hope Sound, please mark separate at the envelope. And if you would like to give for the church, you have Zelle, or in front we have a table, and we can give freely. Okay, let's pray again. Father, thank you so much for this day. Thank you for you, for all the things you gave us, Lord. We are so blessed. We are so blessed to be here to celebrate your name. And thank you for all these things. We pray that all the offerings right now, and we bless all these people in Jesus' name. Amen. About the announcements, we have five announcements to you today, and I'd like to share with you. We have an English class every Wednesday, if you'd like to stay there. It's a great moment. I don't know if Dr. Englund is here. Is he here? Oh, thank you. Thank you for the guys who helped in the English class, and it's a great blessing. And this Saturday, we have work day. It's a preparation for the Easter time. If you'd like to stay with us, it's 8 a.m. You can help us this week. And we need canned for Easter egg hunt. Individually wrapped, it's good for us. If you'd like to bring some candies, it's nice. And next Sunday, it's a business meeting at the church. We see what happened with the church, the health of the church. If after the service, you can stay with us. And next, the last one, it's new discipleship class. We're starting on April. If you'd like to stay in class, it's good to you to share. May the Lord bless you. Thank you so much.
Glorify the name of the Lord. faithful Father. Enduring friend, your tender mercies like a river with no end. It overwhelms me. Covers my sin each time I come into your presence. I stand in wonder once again. Your grace still amazes me. Your love is still a mystery. Each day amazes me.
has proven it time and again. Whatever you've done, wherever you've been, God's grace will always be greater than sin. Broken choices you've made. Sin has a price tag so often you've paid. Oh, but Jesus, he's waiting. New hope is in him, and grace will always be greater.
That was my fault, guys. I turned my mic off. Aren't you glad for that message this morning? God's grace is greater than sin. Now, let me ask you guys a question. Did anybody up here look familiar from last year? Who? Right here? That's because she has been here how many years now? Four years. We've had them 4 years. She's been here every year, and she came with the VBS team that does our VBS. She came the last couple years. Savannah, so good to have you back. How many of you guys have been here all 4 years since we've been having you guys? A whole bunch of them, yeah. Lucas, too. He's the choir director. I hope so. So good to have all of these guys here. Now, let me ask you this. How many of you are TESOL majors? I knew at least one of you. Carissa. It's Carissa, right? Carissa is one of the students that is coming on Wednesday nights and helping teach our English classes on Wednesday nights. Can you give Carissa a round of applause? Yeah, the college is partnering with us on Wednesday nights, their TESOL program, Teaching English to Speakers of Other Language program. Dr. Englund has been coming up for a year now and teaching English classes for free, and taking that time, driving two hours plus up and 2 hours plus back. And some of the students have been coming as well, getting practical experience in the field that they're going to be working in. And what's amazing is this, and I mentioned this, I think, a couple weeks ago, but Carissa, you changed your major, right? What was your major before?
Pre-professional.
That sounds so boring. She was a pre-professional major, and now she's a TESOL major because she came up and was a part of the English classes, and she said, this is what I want to do. Isn't that awesome? Our church is having an opportunity to help shape these young people on a weekly basis, and that's such a thrill for me, Lucas. How many of you guys are education majors? Okay, we got at least 4.5. Okay, 4.5 education majors. How many of you know what we're going to be doing in August of 2024? Somebody tell me. Starting a school. You think we might need a couple teachers? I'd love to get a couple of these young people to come up and teach for us. What do you guys think? Yeah? All right. We'll talk to you guys more about that later, okay? And then, how many of you are worship music majors? We got 3-4 music majors. Did you know that your pastor, your worship pastor, Pastor Matthew, was a worship major at one point at Hope Sound Bible College? He is an alumnus of Hope Sound Bible College. How many ministerial majors do we have? You guys are the best, I'm telling you. This group right here. I used to be in the ministerial department of Hope Sound, and now I'm your pastor. My point is simply this. Yeah, thank you, Bill. Thank you for the one person who's so excited that I'm here. My point is simply this. This group of young people right here has unlimited potential, and they're at Bible college right now seeking to learn and grow and train so they can serve in the kingdom of God. Isn't that awesome? That is amazing. We want you guys to be encouraged when you leave here. We pray for you guys as the college, but the choir, every time they come, it reminds me, I got to pray for those young people. Every time the VBS team comes, it reminds me, I got to pray for those young kids as they're training and preparing. Every time they come and teach English classes, I pray for those young people. Because God is shaping their lives right now, and who knows where God will take them someday. Maybe even here with us. Wouldn't that be awesome? All right. We got a whole bunch of you up here on stage. Future, well, I guess you're Hope Sound alumnus now because you've taken some classes. But how many Hope Sound alumnus do we have? I'm doing your job, John Mark. Hope Sound alumnus here today. Candace. Carl, Pastor Matthew, Butch and Arlene Heath are here. That's my in-laws. I'm an alumnus. Tamla's alumnus. So we've got at least 6 or 7 here today. Just a little plug-in for all the teenagers and all of you up here behind me. Did you know that Bible college is not just a great place to learn how to preach or do music? You can find your spouse there, too. It's great. Pastor Matthew found Candace there. I found Tamla. It's a wonderful place. I'm telling you, Bible college is great. And not so much for my wife. She said, I will never be a pastor's wife. And then she saw me walking across the campus. That's not how it went down, I promise. Okay. But listen, Bible College is a great place, and I'm so glad Hope Sound Bible College is here. Last year, President Stetler retired from being the president of the Bible College. President Stetler spoke at our first men's retreat a few years ago. Most of you remember him. And he was here last year when the choir was here and shared. And Pastor Matt Malloy, that's what he was. President Matt Malloy was here last year. He's not here this morning, but the new head of public relations, John Mark Forsey, is here. I'm going to ask you to come on up. By the way, he just got married. I don't know if you met your wife on the Bible College campus somewhere or not. See, you can find a wife not going to Bible College, but, you know, outside of this couple, I wouldn't recommend it, okay? John Mark, it's so good to have you here. I'm going to give you the mic. I want you to share just a few minutes about the school, anything you feel like led to share. And then one thing before you say something, Pastor Flavio mentioned it. We're receiving a love offering for Hope Sound Bible College today. Anything that comes in as cash in the plates on the way out will go directly to Hope Sound. If you mark it as church, college choir or college, it'll go to Hope Sound. You can do that on Zelle, online, or in the offering today as you leave, okay? We want to give them a good offering. They drove a big, big bus. It takes a lot of gas. I don't know if you notice gas prices nowadays, but they got to get all the way back on the turnpike, too, so that's tolls. So we want to make sure they get back and have a little money on their pocket to help keep doing what God has called them to do. John Mark, here you go.
All right. Thank you, Pastor Adams. Pastor Melvin, okay. Well, I was going to tell you about the school. He didn't leave anything for me to tell you. We're very proud of Pastor Melvin Adams here. He's doing a fantastic job, and thank you. I want to say that publicly. Thank you for allowing us the pleasure of being here this morning. I will promise I will make this short because I have heard there's food after this. You want me to keep it short?
Yes.
All right. We'll keep it short. Like you said, my name is John. Originally, I'm from Michigan, all right? So it's like the opposite end of the country. I'm from where it's cold, and actually Isaac, Emery, and Hannah, they're from Michigan as well. Grew up knowing them, and great people. Glad that they're here. I will say, moving down here to Florida, every time I go back north now, my body has adjusted to the climate down here far faster than I thought it would. So every time I go back north, I'm absolutely freezing. But I am very glad to be down here in Florida. Like you said, we have a new president this year. That's exciting. We have a new gymnasium that's being built. That's very exciting as well. One thing, when I moved to Florida, I didn't understand that up north, when you have a rainy day, it's rainy all day. Down here, it's like 10 minutes and then sunshine. So I'm getting used to that. But we have a new gymnasium that's being built. Also, another thing that Pastor Melvin was talking about, he was talking about the different divisions that we have in our college. One division he didn't mention was we have a counseling division. How many counseling majors do we have? This gives people like me hope. Like, go to those people and tell them all my problems and they can just fix us. And so we're very excited about that. We also have other divisions in our college. We have an aviation program. Elkin, there at the piano, raise your hand. He got his private pilot's license last year. And so now we're looking into getting an airplane for the college, and he can just fly us everywhere. But we're very proud of him and all he's accomplished. Again, he said pretty much everything that needed to be said, so I'll just cut it short. Thank you again for allowing us the pleasure of being here and worshiping with you. Lord bless the choir as they sing one or two more songs, and we look forward to talking with you after the service is complete.
Separated, the breach was far too wide. But from the far side of the chasm, you held me in your sight. So you made a way across the great divide. Left behind heaven's throne to build it here inside. Dead I owed, broke my chains, freed my soul. For the first time I had hope. Thank you, Jesus, for the blood applied. Thank you, Jesus, it has washed me white. Inside my tomb of sin, you were buried for 3 days, and then you walked right out again. And now death has no sting, and life has no end. For I have been transformed by the blood of the Lamb. Thank you, Jesus, for the blood applied. Thank you, Jesus, it has washed me white. Thank you, Jesus, you have saved my life. Brought me from the darkness into glorious.
I believe you, Lord.
Can you say amen and amen to that?
Amen.
Praise the Lord. One thing I forgot to mention is that Hope Sound Bible College, one thing I love and appreciate about the school is that they're founded on the Word of God. They don't deviate from that. So these students are learning what they believe. And in a world that anything goes right now, we need schools that are teaching our young people to stand on the Word of God and His truth. Amen to that? Amen. So last night, laying my kids down to bed, and I tell them, Emmy and Annie, they're always like, are we going to church tomorrow? And I'm like, yep, we're going to church tomorrow. And Emmy said, what are we going to do at church? I said, Hope Sound Bible College is coming to sing. And she said, Hope Sound Bible College? I said, yep, Daddy and Mommy went to that school. Papa and Grammy went to that school. And she goes, I want to go to that school. And I said, okay, well, you're only four, so it'll be a little while, but maybe in a few years, we'll have another choir member up here singing. It'll be Emmy Grace, all right? So so good to have the choir here. They're gonna get off the stage and head on back so you can greet them. You guys want to go ahead and do that? All right? And I want you to say hello to them, encourage them, share how much they mean to you and how much this school means to this church. And make sure they know they're appreciated today. Now that I've said that, it doesn't mean as much when you tell them that. But we're going to let them go on out. And make sure you talk to John Mark and his beautiful young newly married wife. And to Lucas and his beautiful wife and their three children, right? I love having the kids up here. Tell them how much the school means to you guys. We're going to have them for lunch in just a minute, and you're not all invited. Unless Andrea says you are, but I think they were just planning on the choir, all right? But I did invite a couple of my new friends that I just met from Russia. Make sure you, if you see new faces, you tell them how much you appreciate them being here. I actually see a lot of faces, new faces over here, new faces back there, and some new faces here in the middle. It's so good to have all of you guys here today. I'm going to be in the foyer. Make sure you come and say hello to me on the way out and introduce yourself to me, okay? We'd love for you to find out more about the church. And any questions you have, I'm sure we would be willing to answer them, all right? Let's just bow our heads for a closing prayer. Heavenly Father, thank you for your presence as you are here today. May you go with us through this week. Lead us, guide us, give us wisdom. I pray a blessing over this congregation. May they sense your presence. May they be strengthened by your strength. May you give them wisdom for each moment of this week. And may you provide for them according to your riches and your abundance in glory. And we ask this in the name of Jesus. And everyone said, amen. Amen. God bless you. You are dismissed.